What do you think of when you picture a terrifying disease? Do you imagine HIV because it has no cure? Do you picture yourself with organs dribbling out of your anus thanks to Ebola? Or is it more frightening to be trapped inside your own body with locked-in syndrome? Personally, I'm afraid I'll get sexlexia, because even Zap Brannigan's velour hot pants can't cure that. But in the future, could sexlexia be a real thing? And might we have even more terrifying diseases thanks to our reliance on modern technology? Let's find out. In our list of 7 terrifying diseases of the future. Number 7. Virtual reality addiction. Addiction is a disease. It doesn't matter whether you're hooked on hashish, seduced by the sauce, or totally groped by the great gambling gremlin. Some people are just genetically destined to a life of dependency. We are beginning to understand how to help people beat their addictions. But when fully immersive virtual reality becomes available, we may find these strategies no longer apply. Weaning someone off drugs or alcohol has to happen gradually, as the shock of going cold turkey can prove fatal. But how do you coax someone out of virtuality? If someone spent days, weeks, or even months entrenched inside a virtual world, how would their mind react to being prized out of it? Would it be like a second birth? Will Dad be waiting with a camcorder? We've already seen the beginnings of this problem take root with internet gaming disorder and internet addiction disorder. So is it possible that in the future we humans could walk blindly into the Matrix? Or will this only happen to a few of us? And if so, where do we keep all these sleeping people? A virtual reality care home? Now there's a sitcom right there. At 6, Google Amnesia. Don't worry, this isn't an ad for yet another crappy Google product that plugs into your butthole and tells your friends what you had for lunch. Google Amnesia is a serious condition, and it's affecting you right now. Scientists have noticed that people who use the internet remember less of the information learned there when compared to those who gained it from experience or books. A study into this was published in Science magazine in 2011, where college students were shown to remember fewer facts if they knew they could retrieve them easily from the internet later. It's like not bothering to cook because you can have takeout instead. And unfortunately, Google Amnesia can be just as bad for you as living on a diet of pizza and kebabs. Our brains are now conditioning themselves to remember where information can be found and how to access it, rather than storing it directly. The internet, to an extent, has become our brain's external hard drive, albeit one filled with kitty pictures and weird porn gifs, sharing a strange coincidence with my actual external drive. But while this adaptation may seem like a more streamlined way of doing things, it could prove problematic if it continues. Neuroimaging studies conducted on the brains of internet users found that we disregard much of the information we read on the internet because our brains realize that the vast majority of data we find is trivial. So every time we jump online, our mind is ready to skim, not to learn. Therefore, we're less likely to retain much of what we read. Keeping knowledge on hand is crucial to our critical thinking abilities. So there's a strong chance that whole societies of dumb people could form, thanks to Google Amnesia. Apparently, our only chance of avoiding this is to adapt how we process information. But even that may not be enough. In at number 5, sexlexia. Yes, I have included this option solely because Futurama is awesome. But did you know that sexual learning disabilities could one day become a reality? Self-stimulation is becoming ever easier to achieve, and in the future it may require no touching at all, with stimulation created entirely through neural sex toys hooked directly up to your brain. But might we become addicted to them and start to dismiss the knowledge we need to arouse another human? As we've seen with the previous entry, an over-reliance on technology makes our brain adapt and streamline its processes, What if it decides that helping another human get the rocks off is unnecessary? What if sex toys became so elaborate that human-on-human action is entirely eradicated? What if humanity is destined to sit alone in the dark, jacking it for all eternity? Could be worse. In at number 4, compartmentalized personality disorder. In the same way that our brains compartmentalize data and where to obtain it, there's a strong possibility that humans might do the same with their personalities once the use of artificial intelligence becomes widespread. One of AI's predicted uses is through virtual assistants, of which we may have several, and each of whom would be assigned a different version of our own personalities to match their task. Need a raise at work? Here's a super confident virtual you to nail that extra 5%. Trying to woo someone online? Suave virtual you has that date in the bag. Not literally, I hope. We'll save that for virtual weekend psychopath you. But as we give over more tasks to artificially intelligent systems, humans may begin to undergo a personality crisis. Who is the real me? Does one exist? Or are there several versions of me which I need to use at different times? The confusing nature of having to compartmentalize different personalities in the real world could lead to a serious mental breakdown. But don't worry, because at least you'll have 5 virtual shoulders to cry on. 3. Resistant bacteria. In our recent video on the 7 most devastating things mankind could discover, we mentioned the tragic story of one Texas woman who died after being infected with Phantom Menace bacteria, a bacteria that spreads faster than we ever thought possible. Upon detection, Phantom Menace masquerades as something less harmful. But in reality, this bacteria is resistant to every form of antibiotic, meaning we can't treat it, period. And this is just the start. The medical industry has overprescribed antibiotics to the point that highly resistant superbugs are inevitable in the future, unless we can figure out a new tactic to thwart their alarming rise in numbers. Number 2. Nanotoxicity. Nanotechnology could potentially be the greatest creation in the history of man. If we can command swarms of tiny robots to affect both ourselves and the world on a molecular level, then almost anything is possible. Reconstructed limbs, invisibility, unicorns, you name it. But all of this would come only when the technology has been perfected. In its infancy, nanotechnology may cause some serious problems to our health. The effects of carcinogens such as asbestos, tobacco smoke, and Toby Keith's music are well known. But it's entirely plausible that the nanomaterials created by nanobots could accumulate within humans and prove equally toxic, causing unknown side effects. Those little plastic beads in your face wash are a good example, as these are now known to absorb toxic chemicals when dumped down your sink. And we've found significant numbers of these beads in fish and several other areas of the food chain. Drop the scale down to nano-sized particles, and these things are much harder to detect. So when we do unleash armies of tiny robots to do our bidding, let's hope they're programmed to be eco-friendly. And at number 1, unknown genetic diseases. One day, it may be possible to cure genetic disorders such as haemophilia, sickle cell disease, and cystic fibrosis. And it's also likely we'll eventually be able to identify and remove the genes which make certain humans more susceptible to cancer and other genetic conditions. But in doing so, do we risk creating new and even deadlier diseases? Today's genetic disorders are caused by a mutation in one or more genes. But as we begin to edit the code for life, might we unlock entirely new conditions? In all seriousness, though, this is a distinct possibility, and it's hard to know how far down the line such diseases could crop up. Testing genetically modified crops is relatively easy, since their short reproductive cycle means we can find out if they're safe or not several generations down the line. But testing on humans means waiting entire lifetimes. And by the time we find an error, the genes responsible could have been spread far and wide. It's also possible that genetic engineering could be used to create an organism to cure certain diseases. But this too comes with a price. One simple mistake could end up creating a more powerful disease than the one it was supposed to cure. But let's not fear-monger too much about genetic engineering, because we all know that most scientists will be ultra-cautious in its use. However, all it takes is one nut job, with aspirations for terror, and the age of genetic warfare is upon us. Oh great, genetic warfare, that's gotta be the next Call of Duty title, right? Guys, really, just do Vietnam or something. And that's our list. But if you're interested in finding out what your fleshy meatbag is up to right now, take a look at our recent video on 5 mysterious things your body reveals about you.